on the big bucks. One of my next guests is at least trying to change that, introducing legislation that, among other things, encourages Americans to give to campaigns by offering a refundable tax credit for campaign contributions. Democratic Congressman from Maryland, John Sarbanes, and interim president of the Joint Center for Political and Economic Studies, Spencer Overton, join me now. Spencer, I'm going to start with you and the Roberts decision, and I want to read something to you that he said, because it seemed like he's living in a very different world than the rest of us. He said, quote, spending large sums of money in connection with elections, but not in connection with an effort to control the exercise of an office holder's official duties, does not give rise to such quid pro quo corruption, nor does the possibility that an individual who spends large sums of may garner influence or over or access to elected officials or political parties. Now, I think it's pretty obvious just from, like, I don't know, basic everyday experience that that's a flawed, that may be a strong legal opinion, but that is a flawed realistic theory.
Well, it's flawed, a flawed legal opinion as well, Karen. Let's be clear about what this opinion did. You remember Citizens United, the old Citizens United case, it basically allowed corporations to spend on elections. It also led to the creation of super PACs. It did not allow an elected official to ask for a single check of $2 or $3 million. That's what this opinion does. Basically, a candidate can ask a billionaire for a single check of $2 or $3 million. Now, that money is split up among dozens of candidates and federal parties and state parties, but just asking for a $2 or $3 million check can lead to quid pro quo corruption, government favors for cash.
So, you know, Spencer, just to follow up on that, Justice Clarence Thomas basically said in his decision that let's just get rid of all of it. Let's just, you know, and to some degree, I guess my question is, doesn't that kind of just even the playing field? At least then there's no preconceived idea that anybody's playing by any kind of rules.
Yeah, I don't know that it evens the playing field. That's a conventional argument of conservatives, like, let's get rid of all the regulation and kind of even the playing field. The problem with that, though, is that when a candidate requests a $50 million contribution and puts that in his or her own campaign account, there's a real possibility of quid pro quo corruption.
Sure.
We saw that with Watergate and with Nixon in terms of the Watergate investigations, and also, you know, things get tough in terms of democracy's had setbacks,
right,
in terms of the right of women to vote, as well as people of color to vote, but people have pushed on. I think people will push on here.
So, Congressman Sarbanes, I want to talk about your legislation and how you are approaching this issue of campaign mm-hmm. finance reform. Give us an overview.
Well, our legislation started from the premise that the average person out there is completely fed up, frustrated, feels like their voice can't be heard in Washington, in Congress, and that we have to do something to restore some confidence. So a lot of the attention is on what the big donors are doing, and of course McCutcheon opens the floodgates even more, that decision from the Supreme Court. But I want to turn people's attention to how you empower everyday citizens out there so they can kind of get their voice back in the game. So the Government by the People Act is designed to do that. We would offer a small refundable tax credit for contributions to qualifying candidates that come from grassroots donors. We would bring in a multiple match of public dollars behind that to boost up the voice of everyday citizens.
Right.
And if you do that, what will happen, Karen, is members of Congress and candidates won't have to go to the Sean McCutcheons of the world to power their campaigns. They can turn back to everyday citizens, to their constituents, to real Americans, and ask them to power their campaigns and get their voice back into the game.
You know, Congressman, to that point, it's been interesting to see, and we've got a little bit of sound from an ad that Senator Begich is running in Alaska, and what he's essentially done is sort of taken this idea, a lot of candidates have done it, that, you know, Koch brothers funded candidates, that, you know, the idea of millionaires funding candidates, that in sort of similar to the Barack Obama, Mitt Romney kind of, you know, Bain Capital, kind of not a man of the people strategy. Let's take a look at this quick ad.
Ads attacking Mark Begich on a carbon tax have been called false and not true. Who who's behind the attacks.
The Koch brothers.
The billionaire Koch brothers.
I do not believe it.
They come into our town, buy a refinery.
Just running it into the ground.
Leaving a mess.
A lot of Alaskans are losing jobs, and I'm definitely concerned about the drinking water.
I don't go down to tell them what to do. I expect them not to come up to Alaska and tell us what to do.
So, Congressman, I take your point about trying to elevate the voices of smaller donors, of individual Americans, but some look at this and say, well, there's a political strategy to be had here, and again, that, you know, that a certain candidate would be, quote-unquote, you know, sort of bought and paid for. Do you think that's an effective strategy?
Look, I think it's worth pointing out the incredible undue influence that the Koch brothers are having on our political system, and then on the morning that happens after Election Day. But again, I emphasize that it's not just about how we referee the conduct of these big money players. We've got to find a way to empower everyday citizens. If money is speech, then how do you get the speech of everyday citizens into the mix here? And the fact of the matter is that right now, a member of Congress who has to raise an average of $1.5 million every 2 years to win a campaign, if they need to raise that money, there's only one place to go for it, which is to the McCutcheons. We need to create another place to go, which is to everyday citizens. Then we'll answer to them instead of answering to the big money.
Well, I certainly think the other issue here is that we've got to make sure that if money is speech, I mean, part of having big checks and a lot of money means that you can drown out the other side's ability to get their message out. So a lot of issues here. We have to leave it there for now. But thank you, Congressman John Sarbanes and Spencer Overton.
Thanks.
Coming up, we'll look at the state of Black America as President Obama heads to the LBJ Library for the Civil Rights Summit. And conservatives have the answer to all of America's problems. Here it is.
Marriage. Marriage is what brings us together.